Hi there, you're watching the IT Taster channel. I'm John, and in this video, we're going to take a look at identity in Microsoft Windows Server 2016. Coming up right after this. Yeah, so in this video, I wanted to give you a little bit of background on identity because it's something that's really important, so much so that there's a Microsoft exam that is covering it. Identity with Windows Server 2016, exam 70-742. And I'm interested really if, I'm interested to know if any of you out there are currently studying the exam or thinking of studying it. Drop a comment below and let me know if you are. Don't forget, by the way, if you haven't subscribed to the IT Taster channel yet, hit the subscribe button, and if you like the video, give the video a like. It's always helpful to know how well the video is doing. So with that said, let's get started. So let's start with what is identity? Well, identity is all about something called identity and access management. So when you hear people refer to identity, they are really talking about identity and access management. And what we mean by that is how we manage the actual identities themselves, and we'll talk about what the identities are in just a moment, and how we manage what we allow those identities to have access to in terms of network resources. Now, the dictionary defines an identity as a condition of being a specified person or thing. But in terms of computer science and Windows Server, an identity is a user or a computer. Because when we create a new user account, we are in fact creating an identity, a digital representation of a real-world individual. And the same is also true if we join a computer to an Active Directory domain. This process creates a computer account within the domain and creates an identity for the computer. To be able to manage identities, an identity and access management solution, an IAM, is typically made up of the following: an information store, a mechanism to verify identities known as authentication, access control, and auditing. So let's take a closer look at the core components of an identity and access management solution. So let's begin with the information store. An information store is typically a database that stores identities and details about those identities, such as descriptions and attributes, as well as secret information that can be used to verify identities, like passwords, for example. A means of verifying identities is needed. So, for example, when a user logs onto a computer, they're challenged to supply a username and password to verify the identity. The username and password are compared with the information store, and this process is known as authentication. If the username and password are successfully matched with the information store, the user, the identity, can be verified and authenticated. Next is access control. Once authenticated, the user, the identity, can then be assigned access to network resources. Auditing can form part of an IAM solution. Being able to audit identity validation, authentication, both successful and unsuccessful, adds an additional layer of security. Identity and Access Management, IAM, is key to providing security. In Microsoft Windows Server 2016, identity and access management is taken care of by Active Directory. Active Directory is a fairly broad term, which is used to describe the technologies that provide identity and access management and centralized management within the enterprise using Microsoft Windows Server technologies. Now, Active Directory is a whole bunch of technologies. It consists of a suite of services, with Active Directory Domain Services, ADDS, at the very heart. It's the key component that enables us to centrally manage identity in the enterprise. When we install and configure the Active Directory domain services role in Windows Server 2016, the server is promoted to become a domain controller, or a DC. A domain controller hosts the information store, the Active Directory database, and the mechanisms that are responsible for authentication, access control, and auditing. Domain controllers are able to replicate their information stores with other domain controllers. Essentially, the suite of technologies and services that make up Active Directory offer scalability and resilience within the enterprise. Now, I've previously mentioned that Active Directory is a whole bunch of technologies. In fact, it's a suite of services that function as an identity and access management solution, with Active Directory domain services at the heart of it. So let's take a brief look at the suite of services. Let's begin with Active Directory domain services, ADDS. This, of course, is the main component of Active Directory. We then have Active Directory certificate services, ADCS, and this provides us with certificate deployment and management. Active Directory Federation Services, ADFS, enables identity to cross organization boundaries and is also used in conjunction with Azure. Active Directory Lightweight Directory Services, ADLDS, provides us with directory services for directory-enabled applications. ADLDS is something that operates independently of Active Directory. Now, Active Directory Rights Management Services, ADRMS, is about protecting an organization's digital content in terms of how that content can be used, both within the organization as well as extending beyond the boundaries of the organization. Well, that brings us to the end of the video, and I hope you found it helpful, and it's also hopefully given you a better idea of what identity is all about. Don't forget, please subscribe to the IT Taster channel if you haven't already, and give the video a thumbs up if you liked it. You're very welcome to drop a comment below, it's always good to hear from you. And as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.